Hello everyone, welcome back to Placement Buddies. Let me welcome you all to another video in this industrial instrumentation playlist, and today we are going to continue the pressure measurement part. So in the last lecture I told you that there are three types of pressure measurements: low pressure measurements, moderate or medium pressure measurements, and high pressure measurements, right? So we are not going to discuss the low pressure measurement devices. We are going to start from medium pressure measurements. Okay, so the first device which we want to discuss here in medium pressure measurements is manometer. So let me tell you what basically is a manometer, right? So a manometer is something which measures the unknown pressure by balancing it against the gravitational force of liquid heads. Okay, it is used to measure the dynamic pressure as well as the differential pressure, and manometers can be used to measure pressure ranging from as low as vacuum to high pressure of about 0.1 meganewton per meter square. Okay, so this is basically the range of a manometer. Now manometer ke andar jo fluid hota hai, us fluid ke characteristics ke bare mein thoda baat karenge. The fluid which we will keep inside a manometer needs to have low viscosity, low thermal coefficient of expansion. It should be non-corrosive and non-sticky. It should have low surface tension and low vapor pressure as well. So an example of such kind of fluid is mercury, right? Mercury is widely used as a manometric fluid because of its temperature range from -20°C to 350°C, right? So it has a wide operating range of temperature, so we can use it as a manometric fluid. And also it is meeting all the criteria for being a manometric fluid, like low viscosity, low thermal coefficient of expansion, etc., etc., right? So moving forward, let us see what are the type of manometers we have. We have U-tube manometer, we have well-type manometer, inclined tube manometer, and the sensitivity order of such manometers is: inclined tube manometer is having the highest sensitivity, then we have well-type manometer, and U-tube manometer is having the lowest sensitivity among all these three. So we will discuss about all these three manometers in detail, but before doing so, let me tell you what are the advantages of a manometer. A manometer is simple in construction, it will give high accuracy, and along with pressure it is used for the measurement of temperature, flow, and other variables as well. Okay, so as we have discussed about the advantages, let me tell you what are the disadvantages of manometer as well. So a manometer will have poor dynamic response, they will have fragile construction and hence their portability is less. Okay, they have small range of operation of the order of about 1000 kilonewton per meter square, and the final point is dependency on temperature, right? So the manometric fluid density depends on the temperature, and because of this the error may arise on account of the change of temperature. Okay, suppose aap pressure measure kar rahe ho, aur pressure measure karne ke waqt if your device is having some sort of dependency on temperature, then temperature fluctuations ke wajah se aapko accurate reading nahi bhi mil sakti hai. Okay, right. So now let us discuss about the different types of manometer. The first one is U-tube manometer. So as you can see, in the U-tube manometer, the height h, this height I am talking about, the height h, that is the difference in two levels, right? This is level 1 and this is level 2. So the difference in two levels is height h, right? It is a function of the pressure difference. Like here we have pressure P1 and here we have pressure P2. So the height difference which will be there in a U-tube manometer will be a function of pressure difference, and as we all know that P equals to h rho g, right? So here delta P, we will consider delta P, which is equals to P1 minus P2 will be h rho g, right? So instead of rho we will have rho m minus rho f. Rho m will be the specific gravity of manometric fluid and rho f will be the specific gravity of transmitting fluid. Here we will transmit the fluid, right? So this fluid will be the transmitting fluid, and here already there will be a manometric fluid which will be mercury, right? So manometric fluid, rho m will be the specific gravity of manometric fluid and rho f will be the specific gravity of transmitting fluid, right? Okay, now there is a very interesting point to remember, please listen carefully. In a U-tube manometer we have two pressures, right? P1 and P2. Now if P1 is the input pressure, then this U-tube manometer can be used for the measurement of absolute pressure when P2 equals to 0. Agar aap recall nahi kar pa rahe ho ki absolute pressure kya hai, then please watch lecture number 15 of this particular playlist, the immediate last lecture. Okay, There I have discussed what is absolute pressure, what is gauge pressure, what is differential pressure, right? So if P2 equals to 0, then P1 can be used for the measurement of absolute pressure. If P2 equals to atmospheric pressure, then P1 will be used for the measurement of gauge pressure. And if P2 is the second pressure, then P1 can be used for the measurement of differential pressure, right? So we can use this U-tube manometer in order to measure three types of pressures by varying our P2, right? Okay, so this is all about U-tube manometer. Let's proceed further and talk about the well type manometer. So as you can see, a well type manometer is something which is obtained when one of the two legs of an ordinary manometer is replaced by a large well. So as you can see, the one of the two legs is replaced by a large well. Okay, so here we have our well type manometer. Now the last and final one, which is inclined tube manometer. Now in inclined tube manometer, what we do basically is we incline one of the legs. Now due to the inclination of one of the legs, for a small input pressure P1, which is this, the rise of the level of manometric fluid is high, and it is higher than that in case of a well type manometer as well, right? So by increasing the inclination, we are basically increasing the sensitivity. How? Sensitivity means change in output by change in input, right? So here, what is the input? Pressure. And what is the output? Rise in the level of the manometric fluid, right? So if we incline the manometer, then the rise will be more, okay? So change in output will be more, so the numerator will be more, so sensitivity will be more as well, right? So as I have already mentioned earlier, the sensitivity of an inclined tube manometer is greater than that of a well type manometer, which is greater than that of a U-tube manometer, right? So this is all about today's lecture. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the high pressure measurements, right? In high pressure measurements, we have C-type Bardon tube, spiral type Bardon tube, then we have bellows, we have diaphragms, etc. So we are going to discuss these things in the next lecture. Please stay tuned and wait for the next lecture to come. That's it for today. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye.